Imagine taking 3 days with the number one YouTube channel online for entrepreneurs in the world. That is exactly what happened here in Dallas for an event called The Vault. So in this video, I'm going to share with you my takeaways from this historic event. Over 500 people showed up from 41 different countries. Now, people invested between $700 to $4,000 in a ticket and travel and board just to get here. I mean, some people flew from Sweden 24 hours. People flew from Denmark. People flew from South Africa just to be here to spend time with the host of Valuetainment, Patrick Bet-David. Now, it's amazing what the power of capitalism, free enterprise, entrepreneurship can do. Why? We got all sorts of people here. White, black, brown, yellow, purple, Christian, Jews, Muslim, Mormons, agnostic, atheist. We're all here, and guess what? We're all getting along. So in this video, I'm gonna share with you my takeaways from this historic event. Over 3 days, we discovered our capacity and potential over these subject matters, such as day one, identity, position and capacity, values and principles. The second day, problem solving, decision making, systems and protocols. And the third day, strategy and leadership. To top it all off, we had several speakers here, such as Peter Guber, CEO of Mandalay Entertainment and owner of the Golden State Warriors. In spite of his team being in the playoffs, he made it here to the Vault. We also had Patty McCord, the former chief talent officer of Netflix. We also had a real-time former Mafia mob boss in Michael Francezese, who's one of the most watched interview on Valuetainment. His initial interview currently is over 6.6 million views, and we had him here at the Vault. And to top it all off, we had Phil Heath here, seven-time Mr. Olympia bodybuilding champion, dropping a dimes on discipline. Now here's my takeaways. New connections, new relationships. You wouldn't believe the type of people that we'd be going into business for themselves. People that are dissatisfied, people that are frustrated, people that want more out of life, people that have point to prove. Reasons why they're in business, we got to meet them through new connections and new relationships in hallways, over dinner, over lunch, waiting in line. People that have same characteristics and capacities for wanting more out of their life. Second takeaway, learning about new businesses. I thought it was pretty intriguing why people started an app, why people started a stem cell company, why people are expanding the law firm, why people are starting a construction company, why people are going business for themselves with their passion, their interest, or their areas of making the most amount of money today. People going door to door. All sorts of entrepreneurs were here at the Vault. Third takeaway, improving my versatility. What do I mean by that? See, as a coach, as an entrepreneur, as somebody helping people with money, I find it very intriguing why certain businesses are operating in certain models, why people are getting involved in certain markets, why people are seeking certain opportunities, and what is the process of having them pursue that opportunity. I'm very intrigued by that because when I run across into a lot of people and they're facing some difficulties, they're facing some hardships, they're learning to process certain issues and how to get to the next level in their business, if I'm here associating with entrepreneurs in those related fields, I can further help other people by understanding their business. Takeaway number four, understanding opportunities. Many of the people that we see in business today, they may be celebrities, they may be CEOs, they may be big names in the business world. A lot of them were just regular people. They were just thinking differently than most people around them. They had ideas, they had thoughts, and they executed on them. How? By understanding an opportunity. And here at the Vault, I got to understand and develop more opportunities for myself. Takeaway number five, processing issues. So listen, every week for the last going on 4 years now, I spent with Patrick Bet-David how to process issues with my own business. Coming to the Vault, I've understood there's so many more issues that I can do better at in terms of processing and getting over, such as formulas that create trust. Why? Because trust increases speed. Guess what success loves? Success loves speed, especially in this world where people expect customer service, delivering your promises to the marketplace, and helping your newest associates and staff onboard much quicker. And in building and developing a company, so many things can stand in your way. And coming here to the Vault, I understood how to process those issues much faster. Takeaway number six, finding my leaks. As much as I thought I was squared away, as much as my wife and I think that we have a process and a system and a flow going on with our business from coast to coast, Listen, there are still leaks. And come over here outside of our current environment, which is in Chicago, but come into Dallas, come here to the vault, we're able to discover more leaks. The more we can discover leaks and plug them up, the more profitable and much more happier and inspired we'll become. Next takeaway, becoming a better CEO. I realize that I'm responsible for my brand. I realize there's so many things that I'm responsible for to expand and grow our business. Therefore, we can make a bigger impact in our community, create more jobs, and be a much more profitable company. I learned at The Vault how to become a better CEO. Next takeaway, how to inspect my business. You see, in business, we've got to inspect what we expect. And oftentimes, as we have an idea and we execute an idea, how do we know if we're successful? What metrics determines success? What metrics determine that I'm a good leader, then I'm a good CEO? Next takeaway, getting clear on what I want to become. You know, Patrick talked about the next moves. That in chess, after the first four moves, there's over 3 billion moves after even the first four moves in chess. So many different combinations. By being clear on what I want to do and where I want to become will help me align what my next moves are and identify what next moves allow me to go from here to here to here. Because what I want here may be not the next move I need to make here. But if this is what I want, because I'm clear about what I want to become, I can clearly identify the different steps necessary to get me to this point. My next takeaway from the vault is making sure that I leave differently than when I initially came. What do I mean by that? Listen, there's gotta be an outcome coming out of this thing. I gotta make sure that I have a certain metric and a certain result after leaving this event. I just don't wanna be the same type of person 30 days from now, 60 days from now, 90 days from now from when I initially came here. Why? Because if I don't evolve, this investment of time and money was all for nothing. That's why I gotta leave here differently than when I initially came. Next takeaway, it's a little bit of a selfish one, but greater appreciation for our current mentor and current business model at PHP Agency. Now, I was sitting there with my peers, Jason Graziani, Natalie Graziani, sitting there with Jose Gaitan, Rodolfo and Ceci Vargas. You know what we realized? We get the vault type of training, not just once a year like many people that got it here. But we get the vault training, we get the mentorship, the guidance, the data, and the processing of the issues, the data track, the responsibility of staying on top of our numbers every week in what we call the dream team call, which is the top 12 people inside our company. And my sense of greater appreciation as I was sitting there just watching Patrick do his thing, I was actually filling in the answers to some of the things that's inside the notebook. Why? Because we've gone through this type of stuff. And it's so good to see Patrick on this platform, talking about what we get to learn week in, week out, and applying to our lives every year, being expressed and appreciated by everybody here from 41 different countries. And you know what I realized? No one in our entire industry, the insurance industry, is building a company like Patrick. And with that being said, we have such an unfair advantage in our industry. Competition, watch out. Next takeaway, the value in having a mentor. See that guy right there? Patrick Bet-David helps me realize that I have clearly defined a lot of things in my business life that had a lot of ambiguity. There wasn't a lot of clarity before. But now I understand what the value of a mentor brings to me, how financially accountable I am to them, how my implementation is accountable to them. Otherwise, if I'm not handling my money correctly, if I'm not implementing the things that is being taught to me, I might lose a mentor, and I don't want that to happen. So therefore, coming to this event, I realized the value of having a mentor and how much they've done for us in the last three, going on 4 years now. It's meant not only to our bank account, but for the people that we serve. Next takeaway, increasing my identity. Surrounding myself with like-minded thinkers. Surrounding myself with people that are going after it and want to become the next best version of themselves. That forced me in a position where I'm increasing my identity and I'm expecting more of myself. Next takeaway, utilizing case studies. We went through case studies every day, and we realized there's so many different scenarios where it was logical or emotional, where it was favoritism versus capitalism. We went through a lot of different case studies, and I learned a lot about myself, whether objective or subjective to a certain decision. Last but not least, systems and formulas. Bottom line, this is some of the most boring, annoying topics and areas to focus on that I know our competitors don't want to do. That's why I know it gives me as an entrepreneur an unfair advantage in my current industry in the marketplace. And the bottom line, here's what I realized. Patrick has long told us that we want to be the Billy Bean of our industry, that we're using predictive analytics to grow our company. It's not based on talent. is not based on personality, it's based on systems and formulas, and being able to learn those and more of those here at The Vault got me great confidence in writing systems and formulas in my business. My question for you as we wrap up is, are you investing into an environment that allows you an opportunity to grow? Are you in a position where you're constantly being challenged? Or are you the end all be all? Really, are you? You're it? You know why I challenge you on that? Because I know you, me, us, individually, are limited. As an entrepreneur, are you really enjoying the fruits of your labor? Are you running your business, or is your business running you? And bottom line, I hope that you're making an investment to conferences and events part of your personal development and business development plan. Many people here right on the spot signed up for the next conference for The Vault this time next year in 2020. I appreciate you tuning in and listening to some of my takeaways here from The Vault 2019. If you're watching this on Facebook, make sure you click like and follow our business page. If you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you click subscribe, hit notifications to be alerted during our next episode. That being said, thanks for tuning in and thanks for watching. Drop your comments below. I'd love to know what you're thinking and what you got out of this video. So until we meet again, continue to live smart, continue to love smart, and be money smart today.